So, Yogi, what are the chakras?
So the human expression is to experience both physical well-being and reach a higher consciousness. This is the true essence of yoga. Chakras are a tool and framework to achieve this union. There are seven energy centers in our bodies through which prana, which is life force, flows. So at a basic level, you can use the chakras as a framework to understand and address your well-being and needs at a physical level, an emotional level, and a spiritual level. And then, if you look at it from a deeper level, you can use the chakras as a path to reach a higher level of consciousness.
So, Yogi, what fascinates you about the chakras?
So, in my yoga learnings many years back, I was introduced to a chakra workshop. And during that, I realized that my third chakra, which is responsible for physical and mental strength, was very weak, and it blocked all the other higher functions of my being, such as being expressive, being connected, being open. That led me to the path of deep learning about the chakra system and teaching about its benefits.
So, Yogi, what does it mean to balance the chakras?
So, different chakras are responsible for different aspects of our well-being. The first chakra for our physical existence and health, the second for our emotional health, the third for mental and physical strength, the fourth for compassion and love, and the fifth for self-expression and confidence. And then the sixth is responsible for connectedness and connectivity to your true self. And eventually the seventh, which is the Sahasra chakra, is responsible for your connectedness to the universe. So chakra balancing is to get this optimal health at each level, as well as a balance across different aspects of your being. For example, either a lack of compassion or too much compassion, which can lead to grief, are both not optimal. You need a balance. And so chakra balancing achieves that balance in your well-being at multiple levels.
So Yogi, can the chakras be opened or closed?
So chakras are usually represented as petals of a lotus flower or a pipe through which energy flows. Thus, it is easy to visualize their state to be open or closed, which is how it gets referred. Chakras typically, in actuality, are either active when they're energized or weak if they're not energized. So when your chakras are active and balanced, then you get optimal health because of optimal energy flow and thus able to achieve optimal well-being.
So Yogi, why Bali and what can people learn from this workshop?
So Bali has this amazing energy with beautiful landscape, so many temples and such kind people. It is the perfect location to expand your yoga journey, learn beyond asanas, learn more about yourself and also get tools to teach others about chakra balancing. We'll explore the concept of practical techniques of chakra balancing at the amazing One World Retreat in Bali from the 25th November to 1st of December 2018. We will take a very simple, practical approach of chakra balancing with both horizontal balancing as well as vertical alignment. This is achieved by combining yoga asanas with mantras, colors, sacred geometry, meditation, and visualization, and many more elements together to achieve harmony and balance. You'll be able to take with you three unique chakra sessions, as well as a number of techniques that you can use to create your own routine. Come join me at the One World Retreat in Bali.